Married Redditors, what was the most obnoxious request made by one of your wedding guests? Story 1. Not on the day of the wedding, but my monster-in-law requested that my wife's entire family boycott our wedding. When my wife told her mother that we were getting married, her response was, "Why are you doing this to me?" And then told my wife that she wouldn't go and that she would convince her whole family to boycott the wedding. This devastated my wife. She told my stepmom, who took her out to find a wedding dress that day, and she offered my parents' backyard for the ceremony and reception. Well, after my monster-in-law found out that my stepmom took my wife dress shopping, she freaked out, because that was supposed to be something she and her daughter did together, on her mind. And she confronted my wife, and my wife was like, "Why do you care? You're not even going." At that point, the MIL realized it was going to happen without her, and she changed her tune and got on board pretty quick. Story 2. My brother's wife asked me to postpone the wedding a year or two because she was going to try to get pregnant the following year. She also insisted the wedding cake be vegan for religious reasons. I was fine with providing a vegetarian meal option for the few guests I knew would want it. But the cake? No, that's your religion, not mine. She ended up not coming anyways. I'm fine with that. Story 3. My husband and I changed our relationship status on Facebook to married while on our honeymoon. An aunt on his mom's side commented, "Wow," and called his mother, demanding to know why she wasn't invited. My husband and I have been together for 6 years, and I've never met the woman. Of course, we didn't invite her or her flock of kids and grandkids. Not to mention my parents, who paid for the wedding, just built us a house on their farm that was completed 2 weeks prior. We didn't want to abuse my parents' kindness with too many guests. His aunt has gone on to tell the entire family how mean and rude we are. Story 4. It was the handful of guests who couldn't be bothered to retain the address and directions that were provided to them several times via U.S. mail, email, and internet link, and who finally, when all that failed, needed to text me repeatedly to get clarifications on the directions instead of just using flipping Google. You know how busy a person is on their wedding day? I had more important things to do than answer texts about which exit to take. Story 5. For me, the obnoxious part was the stuff people did without requesting it. My dumb little cousin requested to wear a white dress. She's 17 and well on her way to being an Instagram model, so people would have congratulated her all day. And that was still less annoying than the part where my mother-in-law, without notifying anyone, brought a flipping of potted succulents because she had heard there would be no flowers. And I had absolutely spent hundreds of dollars on flowers already. So I could tell my white dress-wearing cousin to shut the fudge up and change, but I had nothing prepared for a pallet of cactus out of the blue. We still grumble about that one. Story 6. I've made this comment before elsewhere, but it's always worth a retell. I'm a wedding photographer. Last year, the mother of the bride wanted the DJ to help her play a game at the reception. The game was this. The bride sits blindfolded on a chair while the groom and groomsmen circle around her. She then has to feel their junk and guess which one is the groom. The DJ was inexperienced, but had minimal enough common sense to come ask for my professional opinion. I told him if he wanted to keep his job, he would never in a million years do that, and if MOB comes back, he needed to keep conveniently forgetting about it. Story 7. The day before the event, husband's grandma asked if any part of the wedding was going to be outside. It was. She asked what would happen if it was cold in May. I told her she should bring a jacket. She said incredulously, "But I'm 80 years old." To this day, I don't know what she expected me to do to make the weather not chilly or her not 80. Story 8. I had a small wedding and our budget included putting all 16 attendees, ourselves included, up in the bed breakfast that we held our ceremony dinner in. The day of the wedding, my mother tried to pressure my husband and I into switching from the honeymoon suite into the room she and my father were in with my kid sister. Small bed, crowded, and a creepy mini bed in the closet for my kid sister. Unless I misunderstood her, we would have also had to share the room with my kid sister on our wedding night because of the spare bed being in that room. She only asked because she thought that the whirlpool bath in our room would be nice for her back. I told her no, that we had specific plans for the bathtub that night, and she dropped it. Story 9. My grandmas, both of them, left the room when we did our toasts because we used actual champagne. We offered the non-alcoholic sparkling juice stuff for them, but that was not acceptable because it looked like alcohol. They were so offended that we were drinking they refused to participate and returned once the toasts were done. Story 10. A few days before my wedding, my husband's aunt called us wanting to do individual family photos. I had a photographer I paid for that was working on my schedule, and now she wanted to make arrangements with me to get individual family photos. I refused to entertain the idea of it and said, I find it extremely rude she would call the bride with less than 5 days till the wedding and ask a huge favor and change in the wedding. Well, then a bunch of people got involved. I told them all no and I won't hear any more of it. If you want family photos, hire your own photographer. Story 11. At my sister's wedding reception, our cousin asked her and my new bro-in-law if she could stop the music and dancing while she sang a song she had written about their wedding. My sister was annoyed but agreed because, wow, she wrote this song just for them. So we all stop dancing and stand around awkwardly while she sings this long, long Luwung song that doesn't really make sense but has to do with love or whatever. A few weeks later, my sister finds out through Facebook that this cousin sang the exact same song at multiple other weddings. The nerve. Stopping weddings dead in their tracks to be the focus of attention by lying that the song you're singing was written just for them. We all got a good laugh out of that. Story 12. Our culture dictates that we pay for our guests' hotels. Not a big deal. Anywho, we had an uncle come in, check in, decide, nah, and left for another hotel paid for by his son, who is pretty well off. That meant that we had to pay for his hotel room even though he didn't stay there. My wife was PO'd. It's all good. His son, my wife's first cousin, is pretty cool and makes it up with gifts for our daughter. Story 13. Her dad's side of the family wanted us to pay for all their hotels and airfare. Would have been about 20K, all said and done. When we refused, they said we weren't being inclusive to the part of the family that had to travel and would not be attending. Yeah, they're 16 hours away, but my family is about 20 hours away and they had no problem arranging their own transportation. Story 14. My father told me he was willing to give us money toward our wedding, but he demanded to be able to invite a huge list of guests in addition to our already planned list. I kindly told him that the extra expense of feeding those guests would exceed the money he wanted to give us, and we declined the gift. The other obnoxious thing was my aunt giving a toast after the best man. Unplanned. Unwanted. Story 15. We're from different countries, so we had one wedding near all her family with a small group of my close family friends flown in, and then the same near my family with some of her family friends flown in. The night before the wedding in her country, her family had a small party at the house they were sharing for the event. I was expected to be there, but my family and friends were explicitly not invited and told not to come. They had flown halfway around the world for this and were expected to spend the night before the wedding just hanging out at their hotel. At the wedding near my family, I had about a half dozen of my family members who either didn't RSVP or RSVP'd that they would not be coming, who then decided 3 days before the wedding that they would come after all. But instead of calling me directly so we could inform the venue, pay the extra money, and reorganize the seating, they just casually mentioned it in passing to my grandmother, who then casually mentioned it in passing to my mom the day before the goddamn wedding. So both of our families contain some inconsiderate assholes, I guess. Story 16. My ex told me about when she finally did get married. Her big family all plainly said they would attend. Her passive-aggressive mother got all her siblings to come to their house so everyone could ride with them in their large Suburban and make it a family trip together. My ex waited and waited and no sign from her family and no cell reception from any of her brothers and sisters. The next morning, her and her new husband are woken by her family expecting them to cook breakfast. They had lived only a few hours from Yellowstone Park, but decided on their daughter's wedding day was a perfect day to finally go, and the next day just wake them up to make them cook. Story 17. We made it clear that children were not invited to our wedding. We saw it as a way for parents to take a night off, party a little, relax, sleep in, etc. Plus, we had to pay for those plates, there was no chicken nuggets on the menu, and our families have over 30-plus kids total. I had a cousin call me 2 days before the wedding stating that there was no way they could come without their 3-year-old, and that we should pay for their room if we wanted them to attend, or they would not come. They did not attend, but they did send a card we got about 2 months later that just said congratulations. Story 18. My, unfortunately, now S-Yil, while completely at 3 p.m. on a Wednesday, as she is prone to doing, got up on a table in a restaurant and screamed at me and my husband for daring to plan our wedding before she and my brother got engaged. Said brother told her a few days later that he had no intentions of getting married no matter the person. And suddenly a month later, she's magically pregnant. The actual request, if you can call it that, was for us to postpone our wedding by another year so she could have her baby shower that weekend. Yeah, that didn't happen. Story 19. We asked people to let us know if they had any allergies or religious dietary requirements. Some people came back to us with preferences of ingredients they didn't like, a fact that became quite obvious after I had to clarify how serious the allergy was and if other related ingredients might cause an issue. How pretentious can you be? Story 20. It wasn't a guest. It was the owner of our reception venue. We hired a restored Victorian house for our reception. It didn't include any catering, drinks, tables, or chairs. Just an empty room, we supplied everything else. Obviously, this meant we had to coordinate a bunch of vendors. From the moment we started inquiring, the deal was that the owner would hand us the keys to the house the night before the wedding. We would hand them back the morning after the wedding. Whatever we did in between was our business, as long as the keys were returned on time and the place was left as we found it. The night before the wedding, my bridal party and I went to the venue to set up. We were all done and about to leave when the owner appeared and demanded I give him back the keys. We argued extensively. He eventually threatened to cancel our booking, so I reluctantly handed them over. He promised that he would be present to let the caterers in at 4 p.m. the next day. I didn't trust him, so I sent my dad to the venue at 4 p.m., straight after the ceremony, to be sure. Lucky I did. 4 p.m. rolls around and the doors remained locked. My dad calls the owner, who says he's gone for a lovely drive in the country with his family. He's half an hour away and has beau plans to return anytime soon. My dad is not a man who lets anyone fudge with his baby girls, so he gave the owner hell and threatened legal action, so the owner returns and lets our vendors in, half an hour late. The next morning, the day after my flipping wedding, I get a phone call from the owner at 7 a.m. I was fast asleep, so it went to voicemail. He leaves a message demanding that I return the keys he took off me the night before the wedding. He called again at 8 a.m. and left a message saying he had found the broken key fob, electronic keys, in the driveway of the venue, and telling me that I would be paying for replacements. Again, he took the keys off me before the wedding. He had them all along. If they got lost or broken, it was his problem, not mine. I eventually surfaced at about 9 a.m. and called him back. I am a flipping monster when I'm hungover, so I tore shreds off him. He tried to say he never took the keys off me. I offered to bring my 8 flipping witnesses to court to testify that he flipping did. That made him change his tune pretty quickly. So yeah, I'd say calling me at 7 a.m. the morning after my wedding to demand something I never had was the most obnoxious request I got. Story 21. My mom was really late to the ceremony, and we waited for her. Edit. I didn't have access to my computer for leisure time. I have a test on Friday that I needed to study for, but I wanted to offer some more background. My mom had a really bad drinking problem for many, many years, since I was 12 or 13. She was drunk that morning, was upset that the day wasn't about her, and was so drunk that she couldn't be ready on time. We had a really small wedding, and the ceremony was supposed to start at 2. It started at 3 instead. We had a job, so the ceremony lasted like 0.5 minutes. Then we took pictures. She'd done something like this before, for my college graduation, but I let it go. The reason why I didn't talk to her for a year was because I told her that she needed to get sober before we could interact again. She got upset with me and chose to continue to drink. 6 months into our talking hiatus, my dad told me she checked into rehab. She's been sober ever since, 6.5 years. My sober mom is actually a cool and interesting person. I convinced her to start volunteering, and that got her out of the house and made her the person I suspected she always was. Caring, charismatic, and very patient. She even got a part-time job. Over the 7 years, she looks better, younger, and more vibrant. Story 22. A friend threw a fit because she wanted to take her children to the wedding. I said that they would not have a babysitter on site. There would be no accommodations for any children, nor special menu for them to eat, and that we were out of chairs, and that she was welcome to bring them if they could be squished inside, but no special treatment for any kids was expected. Story 23. My mother complained about our and gold wedding invitations. It absolutely devastated her that I'd use such a funereal color scheme, and she sent a long email about how terrible they were. I asked my aunt or sister what she was expecting me to do. Resend the invitations? Bonus points? Guess what color her dress was at my wedding? Story 24. Emil wanted us to have a destination wedding at a resort in a tropical country. She spent months trying to get us to do this. Neither of us liked the heat. But hey, that didn't stop her from making my CL and her husband, who both also disliked the heat, get married in Cuba 2 years earlier, so I kind of blame them for enabling her. Story 25. This happened to my mom at her and my dad's wedding. Her own mother sat out in the car until everyone went inside and then made both my grandfathers escort her inside. Also, she wore all like it was a funeral. This was because she didn't like my dad. Now fast forward to my brother's wedding. My mom was helping the bride's mom set up the wedding venue and decorate. The same grandmother wanted only my mom to pick her up. But when my mom said she was too busy, because of wedding stuff, obviously, and my dad said he would pick her up, my grandmother threw a fit and didn't come to the wedding. Fast even more forward to my wedding. Said grandmother wasn't there either. She was visiting my uncle a state away. Not really drama or anything, but yeah, she made lots of things about her. Story 26. Everyone was cool for the most part. However, we invited my friend, old roommate, and his girlfriend. But between the time invitations went out and the wedding, they had broken up. She asked us if she could bring the new guy as her plus one, and we had to tell her that she was actually the plus one originally, and had to basically uninvite her. If she didn't say anything, she would have remained invited due to mindlessness on it. At first we felt bad, but we quickly got over it. She didn't really know anyone else at the wedding, so she would have either tried to hang around us, which wouldn't have worked with the 1,000 ways we were getting pulled, or with her ex. It was a situation begging for drama, so we nipped it in the bud. Story 27. My husband's aunt found out that our dogs were going to be our flower girls. She decided this meant she could bring her dog to the wedding. Her aggressive, misbehaving, terrible dog. Several people told her the dog couldn't come, but she claims that it's a therapy support dog. It's not. She showed up the night before the wedding with the dog anyway. As soon as it got out of her car, it attacked my younger dog. She insisted it was just a misunderstanding. An hour later, it attacked my older dog. She insisted it was my dog's fault, and in order to avoid drama, I put my dogs in the house. The next day, during the ceremony, my dad was about to help me onto my horse to walk down the aisle, and he sees the dog, sitting in the front row right next to the aisle where my dogs will be walking. There is going to be a dog fight during my wedding. I'm sitting on this horse, who's afraid of flowers, which is another story for another time, and my dad takes off running down the hill. My lovely aunt-in-law refuses to move, refuses to take her dog elsewhere, and argues that her dog is not the problem, so she shouldn't have to move. My dad lost it, got an old friend to pick the dog up and carry it away from her and out into the back. It wasn't pretty, but I made it down the aisle, and my dogs behaved perfectly throughout the ceremony. The old friend kept the aunt's dog with him all night. The aunt didn't really even protest, and he missed everything. My wedding was beautiful, but behind the scenes, it was a nightmare. Story 28. Sister-in-law had to have a birthday cake for the boyfriend's daughter. Why? Because she was turning 6 and would remember this birthday forever. We were horrible people for planning a wedding on this day. She had to have the DJ say that this is her day too, and they had to have special cupcakes for her at our rehearsal dinner. Why couldn't they celebrate another weekend? Well, I think we all know the answer. For the record, sister-in-law is no longer dating the boyfriend. Story 29. After the ceremony, we did family pictures like you do. The photographer and I were both calling out to various people for different group shots. Now I have a very mixed family. My mom's parents are divorced. My parents are divorced. I still had great-grandparents, plus my new in-laws and all of that. We called out and said, all of obsolete 16's grandparents get in this picture. My grandmother, two grandfathers, and one of the remaining great-grandparents posed, and we thought all was good. Then my husband and I left to go have some extra pictures of just the two of us done in an old cabin on the property. By the end of this, we're both done with photos. The bridal party and our families had gone off to start partying. Many of the guys had already changed into more comfortable clothes and so on. We get back to the main area, and my step-grandmother, mom's stepmother, is pissed. She's throwing a fit because we're having the wedding at her house. And she wasn't in any of the pictures. To keep things peaceful, my mom pulls my husband and I and the photographer back to where the photos were taken. But that's not enough. We had to round up the bridal party and the rest of my mother's side of the family to pose for pictures with this woman for almost half an hour. We ended up with more posed photos with her and them than any other family member. Then, after the photos, she was still being a bad person. She was complaining about our music, the food, the decorations, the strange people she didn't know, my new in-laws. It was obnoxious. Eventually, she decided to leave, and we had a good time, but that first hour was awful. Bonus. At the rehearsal dinner, my husband's sister announced her second pregnancy because heaven forbid a day goes by where she is not the center of attention. Story 30. My dad insisted that his band get to play at our wedding. I and my wife were dead set against it. My dad would not stop asking over and over again to let his band play at the reception. We kept saying no, so he decided to get creative. He calls me up one day and says he is paying for our honeymoon and that he has booked us a cruise to Mexico. He then asks again if his flipping band can play at the wedding. I talk it over with my wife, and we compromised that they can play at the reception hall for a couple hours between the actual wedding and the reception. Wedding was kind of early, 3 p.m., and reception was at 5 p.m. We figured his band could entertain people while they waited for us to show up. We provided drinks and snacks for people that went straight to the hall. While my wife and I are having pictures taken, I text a friend and ask how my dad's band sounds. He says they aren't playing. I'm confused now because we explicitly told him when they could. So now I'm of the understanding that my father's band isn't going to be performing. We get to the reception hall and see that my mother had rearranged everything while we were getting pictures taken. The head table we set up, the way we wanted the tables grouped, she moved everything. So, of course, my wife bursts into tears seeing how everything had been moved. We actually have a picture of me seeing that everything had been moved with a blank, expressionless look on my face, and then a second pic of my wife noticing and the look of shock and sadness. So the wedding reception beings. My dad comes up to and starts trying to negotiate when his band will play. We already paid for a DJ. I told him it's not possible anymore. He persists. Dinner served. When can my band play? Toast by best man. When can my band play? First dance by the couple. When can my band play? It gets to the point that my best man starts fighting with my dad. They're screaming at each other, and my best man is yelling, "Stop bringing up the flipping band!" Here's the best part. They weren't even flipping there yet. And when they did arrive, they all brought their whole flipping families. After a few hours at the reception, I told my dad that his band could play whatever they wanted. Then my wife and I left. Oh, and my dad didn't perform in this band. He just wrote songs for them. It took my wife a solid 5 years to be able to be in the same room with my dad again. Edit. Totally forgot to add, my dad never paid for the honeymoon, he just paid the deposit. He basically picked my honeymoon and then paid $500 towards it. Here's a pic of the infamous band, All That Equipment is where our dance floor was supposed to be. We left by the time this picture was taken. Just as an aside, I could have sewed the bottom of it up and used it as a sleeping bag. My wife says that's why she doesn't put any pictures of me from the wedding up. She doesn't want to explain to guests why I look like a kid wearing his dad's coat. Also, that's my best man in the back that tried to get my dad to stop harassing us. Story 31. Married last week. My. Emil wanted to bring my husband's half-brother, but my husband didn't want him there. She said she wouldn't come, and if she didn't come, most of the family we invited wouldn't show up either. So we had to invite the half-brother to keep the peace. The wedding rolled around, and who didn't show up? The half-brother. My Emil pulled a lot of nonsense on us regarding the wedding planning. Story 32. My high school friend, not even best friend, made me swear at 18 that I would make her a bridesmaid. When I got married, I followed through, to my poor judgment. This girl showed up unannounced 2 days prior to the wedding expecting to stay with me at my parents' house. Didn't show up to our wedding party nails appointment, which I paid for. Spilled Chick-fil-A sauce on her bridesmaid dress the day of the wedding because she was eating in her car, forgot her shoes at the hotel that I paid for, and had to go back, but refused to use a GPS and spent an hour trying to find her way back to the salon. Hit on one of the groomsmen who was already engaged and never spoke to me after the wedding. It's been over 5 years. Oh, she also off all her hair a week before the wedding, save for a long rat tail in the back. Story 33. My uncle was invited, but I don't have a relationship with his children, I just don't know them. And we were having a small wedding, so they weren't invited. He RSVP'd for himself and his two adult children. I called him and finally relented on him having them come. None of them showed up to our wedding. That was $150+ of food wasted. Two guests of which I didn't even want to begin with. People stick to your original list and forget anyone you don't want there. Edit. Misspelled word. Story 34. My best man's plus one, who was essentially a long-term fudge buddy, asked if she could bring her own plus one since the best man would be doing best man things all day, and she didn't know anyone. My wife and I respectfully declined this request. She never made an effort to get to know his friends anyway. Then one night I was drunk and talking to my best man on the phone, and talking a ton of nonsense about how ridiculous it was that she wanted her own plus one. I think I was peeved about her never wanting to hang out with his friends. Anyway, she was with him at the time of the phone call, and my drunken loudness was enough for her to hear everything I said. So after that, my best man no longer had a plus one. Story 35. I'm not married anymore, but one of my bridesmaids was a Chinese woman that I worked with. The invitation clearly stated adults only reception and was addressed to her and her husband only. I received her RSVP card back for 6 people. Her, her husband, their 2 kids, and both of her parents. Thankfully, I was able to explain to her that I didn't think her kids would enjoy the reception, etc., and successfully brought her back down to planet Earth. I think it was a cultural thing. I've been to Asian weddings before, and they are huge and awesome, but I certainly couldn't afford to feed her entire family. Story 36. For my wedding, I asked one of my only, at the time anyway, nephew to be the ring bearer. His mom, my now ex Sil, was upset that her son was going to have a part in the wedding, but her daughter wasn't. She asked that I make my niece either a bridesmaid, I already had 2 and felt that was enough, or a flower girl. Niece was too old to be a flower girl, I felt. Plus, I already had 2, another niece plus one of my mom's friend's daughters. I told her no and let it go. A few weeks later, she sent me an email demanding I find something for her daughter to do in the wedding. Fine. She could sit by the door to the reception and make sure people signed the guest book. SEL replied that she wanted me to have niece help me open the wedding gifts at the reception, and I was like, no. I gave her something to do. If you don't like it, tough. Pretty sure, now ex still never forgave me. Story 37. I cater weddings, and the most recent one was a guest going waist, deep into this pond at the venue trying to catch a koi fish. Then at the end of the night, when everyone had left besides the bride and the groom, they notices that someone had left their 3-year-old kid in the corner sleeping, so they had to take the kid not knowing who he belonged to. Story 38. My mom's cousin, my first cousin once removed, apparently, asked my mother if she could invite her houseguest to our wedding. Her houseguest was a candy addict that my mom's cousin and her husband were trying to rehabilitate. They wanted the addict to come to the wedding because they didn't trust him alone in their house. So yeah, my mom correctly said, no, edit, words. Story 39. We didn't invite my husband's grandfather to the wedding. They have never been close, and last time I saw him, he harassed me and my brother-in-law's girlfriend. We told he could be invited if he apologized, and he declined. Husband's uncle was angry about it, left early, and has been fighting with my MIL about it ever since. Seems like he and grandfather are from the same cloth. Story 40. A couple that were annoying at the time, but a decade later now just make us laugh. One, we were adamant that no kids were invited. We had no children in the wedding party and no one under 18 was invited to the reception. So there was no picking and choosing. It was no kids across the board. For some reason, my husband's uncle thought he was magically exempt from this and planned to bring his 9-year-old daughter to the wedding anyway. Thankfully, we caught wind of his plan about 2 weeks before the wedding. ML mentioned it in passing. And my husband called him and said, "Hey, our own nieces and nephews aren't coming, so your daughter can't come either. We can't invite some kids and not others. I understand if you're unable to come because of this, but we need to be fair." Miraculously, his uncle found a sitter for his daughter and came to the wedding himself. 2. My ILs are pretty oh no cheap. They offered to pay for nothing for our wedding, which is fine. My husband and I were working professionals in our 30s when we married and were more than capable of paying for our own wedding, which is exactly what we did. Imagine our surprise when our MIL gave us a list of people we needed to invite to the wedding. Her own friends, colleagues, distant relatives my husband had only met once or not at all. After the shock of this ludicrous request wore off, I just looked at her and said, "Well, Mill, the reception hall is $75 plate. So if you'd like to invite these guests, then give me their addresses and a check to cover their plates." Well, that shut her up mighty quickly, and that was the last I heard of it. Money talks, nonsense walks! Story 41. Our photographer told my wife to change out of her wedding dress before the ceremony to get some other pictures. I don't think I've ever seen my wife that mad, ever. Truthfully, the best diffuser for all angry moments. Remember that time you wanted to murder the photographer? Good times. Story 42. My ML asked what she needed to wear, and what time did she need to show up at the park? Which would have been fine, except that she wasn't invited, because we were having a very small wedding with 6 guests and a friend to officiate. She then invited her kids, her siblings, their kids, etc. We ended up eloping the day we picked up the license, mostly because when the clerk asked if we had any questions, I jokingly asked if we could Judy get it officiated at the courthouse that day. Got married by a pirate, really a judge that had a hook instead of a right hand, while wearing jeans and a sweater. Went to Dave and Buster's with our close friends instead of having the wedding. I think we all had a way better time. Story 43. Obligatory not my wedding. My grandparents had a small church wedding in the early 1950s. My grandma wore a lovely traditional gown with a high collar, think Grace Kelly. Her 3 bridesmaids had similar dresses, except theirs were T-length, cap-sleeved instead of long-sleeved, and of course not white. Now, her 1 bridesmaid showed up to the wedding, not in that dress, but in a full-length beauty contestant-style gown, shiny satin, low neckline. Even wore a tiara and held a big bouquet. My grandma, being the nonchalant, awesome woman she is, thought it was a little odd, but never said a word to her friend about it. I don't think she wanted to give her the satisfaction. In fact, she never told us that story until my cousins and I found pictures with the whole wedding party and asked why Miss America showed up to her wedding. Story 44. It was from my aunt, actually. Me, my husband, and our wedding party had just sat down at our table to eat since we had been taking pictures. I didn't know this happened till after the wedding, but my aunt went up to my mom and a friend and was tearing into her saying she deserved a seat at our table, since she helped us with the reception and that they needed to figure something out and pull a chair up for her. My mom's friend diffused the situation thankfully. My aunt has been drinking at this point too, but it made me realize never to accept anything from her again, since now I know she will hold stuff over us like that. Story 45. Right before my ceremony started, my wife, the bride, was ready to walk down the aisle. The photographer for our wedding was snapping pictures as she walked up to the church where she would enter. The photographer then said she was going to the front of the church to get the bride walking down the aisle and take normal wedding pictures. This is when our wedding coordinator said that it was church policy that no photographers were allowed in the sanctuary. My wife had to hold back tears, she was so furious. Her dad almost punched the coordinator. Our only picture of our actual ceremony is when she was able to crack the doors at the back of the church and take a picture down the aisle. Story 46. A family member on my husband's side asked if they could have 10 seats rather than the 3 they had RSVP'd. Even though it was only a couple weeks away from the big day, it was no biggie, actually. I didn't know his family well and thought it'd be nice to meet more of them. So we added 7 meal seats to our total and gave them their own table. On the wedding day, 0 of the 10 showed up. No notice, no excuse. They were the only guests to not attend. In hindsight, it's annoying a ridiculous request. Thankfully, on the day of, we didn't notice care. Story 47. The number of people who thought they were entitled to come see me in my dressing room was astounding. Everyone thinks that they're special because they know the bride. But guess what? At least 50% of the guests at this wedding know the bride. Unless you are immediate family or part of the bridal party, you can wait with everyone else. We had experience from previous weddings with people wanting to come into the dressing room and knew to try and head people off before they could get in, but I still had one coworker slip in while my MOH was trying to close the door. So not only did she come into my changing room, this is literally where we change clothes, GTFO, but she also stayed way too long and wanted to get pictures. I let her take a picture to try to get her to leave, but specifically told her that she could only send it to another coworker who couldn't make it to the wedding, and she absolutely could not post it online. Oh, and she was wearing white. Story 48. My best flipping friend of 15 years and maid of honor turned down the idea of bringing her family to my out-of-state wedding only to demand she either leave at the beginning of my reception or she get to bring only her six-month-old, less than 2 weeks before my wedding. We discussed everything in depth. She thought she could walk down the aisle carrying her six-month-old. She had no plans on if the baby started crying, stating, "Is it really a big deal if she fusses?" Yes. Yes, it is. Anyways, she gave me options. Either the baby comes, or she comes late and misses the rehearsal. I chose that she missed the rehearsal. She got mad because apparently the option I chose was wrong, so she completely ignored me for a week. So that brings us to a week before my out-of-state wedding. She finally talks to me. But at this point, I'm pissed. I compromised and she ignored me. I had her food and lodging set up. She literally only had to pay for her dress, $99, and her plane ticket. I even chose a vegan-friendly restaurant for the rehearsal dinner for her. I was always there to support her and celebrate her. I threw her a birthday party in middle school. I was there when both of her kids were born. I helped throw her baby showers. Why couldn't she give me one flipping weekend? What helped me make up my mind was my husband asking me, "What has she done for you lately?" I didn't have an answer. So by the time she stopped ignoring me, I replaced her in my wedding and told her she wasn't invited and we weren't friends anymore. I flipping loved her and I cried for days, but she's a huge brat and I'm done with worrying about her and her problems. Story 49. This isn't really a big deal, but at the time it was very frustrating. My husband and I had a relatively small wedding of about 80 people, and we paid for the whole thing ourselves, with the exception of the desserts that his mom bought. Our families were not involved in the planning at all. This is important, because a month or so before the wedding, my mom's brother's girlfriend texted my grandmother to say they'd try to come to our wedding. They weren't invited! I have never met my uncle's girlfriend. I haven't seen my uncle in years, and my husband hasn't met him in the 10.5 years we've been together. The most interaction I have with him is on Facebook, where he occasionally likes my posts. They live a few states away and had actually come down a couple months before our wedding to go to a theme park but hadn't reached out to me, despite the fact that we live about 20 minutes from that theme park's. Why would they come to our wedding? My mom is the one who told me that my uncle was going to try to come, and I told her no, he's not. And if he shows up at the venue, he won't be able to get in. She didn't understand why it was a big deal, and my grandma offered to pay for their meals, meaning she thought it would be easier to pay about $200 for their food instead of simply reminding them that they were never invited. There wasn't enough room for them even if she did pay for their meals, and anyway, I didn't want them there. If someone isn't comfortable enough with the bride or groom to speak with them about attending the wedding, they should realize they weren't invited for a reason. In the end, my grandma's solution was to ignore my uncle and his girlfriend's texts and calls, and they did not show up. I don't know if they actually cared that much. A few other family members wanted to invite people, but this was the most annoying one because, and mom and grandma were pretty insistent. Oh, and my uncle never congratulated us. Story 50. They didn't attend, but my father and his bad person wife tried to make my siblings choose between attending my wedding or going on their dream vacation. Unfortunately, my siblings are not that easy to manipulate and chose my wedding. So they didn't get either trip, and we were only informed too late to get father's ex-wife and her lawyers involved. I'm my father out of my life at that point. All my siblings followed suit within 2 years. Story 51. I didn't have the best relationship with my mother, and I refused to have anything to do with my oldest sister. My mom lived 90 minutes away and had arranged for a close family friend to bring her. Since the friend was coming, she was invited to the rehearsal dinner. Something came up and she could no longer come. Mom asks my sister to bring. Sister is not invited. I figured since her son lives nearby, she can visit him during the dinner and just hang at his apartment during the wedding. Or with friends, since she used to live here. To note, my nephew was invited and did come to the wedding. Well, that didn't sit well with mom or sister. They thought sis should be at the rehearsal dinner. I stood my ground and they ended up staying home and getting drunk instead. Fine by me, we weren't paying for the dinner. My FEL planned and paid for it at the country club. My sister would have shown her peach, started a fight, and got stumbling drunk. Hard pass. Story 52. We had made the guest list and arranged for the proper-sized venue. We were allowing most people to RSVP for themselves and one extra. One of my cousins, whom I hadn't seen in several years, wrote back asking if she could bring her husband, a friend, and their 4 kids. I was taken aback. Are you serious, 7 people? I talked with my fiancé and we decided sure. We'd squeeze them in. mostly because I hadn't seen this cousin in so long. It would be really nice to see her again. Day of the wedding, they no-showed, one table completely empty, and she never bothered to give a reason as to why they didn't show. I refuse to talk to her now, so rude. Still blows me away after all these years. Story 53. My husband and I set our wedding date as November 19th, 2013, and like a week later, Disney said they are premiering the movie Frozen at the El Capitan Theater in Hollywood. And we lived in Hollywood at the time. We are Disney fans, and we had passed away hard Disney fans as friends. About six people asked us to move the date so they can see the premiere instead of our wedding. Story 54. My dad's wife's family, aka stepfamily, got upset because I didn't give them a better job or a more significant role in the wedding. They have done nothing but been a nuisance in my life and then expect me to, like, put them in the wedding party? Hell no! They still can go fudge off! Flipping, eh? I hate them! Story 55. For my wedding, my dad had offered to pay for everything, with an interesting definition of everything. Biggest issue, he wanted to have free booze for himself and all of his friends, but not for people he didn't know. Suggested various ways. His first was that he'd park his motorhome right outside and have a friend pouring drinks for people he recognized. We pointed out that was kinda illegal, and if he tried it, it would be a race as to who would call the cops first, us or the hotel. Then he suggested that the hotel have an open bar that took vouchers. He'd have an endless supply of vouchers that he could hand out, and everyone else would get one. At this point, he was expecting me to compliment him on his cleverness and generosity. We ended up with no open bar at all. I think he told his friends to run a tab and bring it to him afterwards. Not much I could do about that. His offer included the pre-wedding dinner. It had to be at a nice restaurant, include plenty of courses, prime rib had to be an option, drinks included, with a cost per head of something rather low. I think it would have been on the order of $1.10 head, if I'm applying inflation correctly. Ended up with the dinner he asked for and had the restaurant prepare one bill that covered the first $10 of everyone for him to pay and a second one for me. Although two of his guests canceled at the last minute, he told me they weren't coming literally as we were getting out of the car, and since he wouldn't pay for their meals, so I had to cover an extra $1.20. Their food was already prepared. The reception dinner was a buffet. I think he actually did cover all of that, but then it really was pretty cheap per head. The most obnoxious issue was that he would not pay for anything or even condone the wedding. He phrased it as allow, as if he could have stopped it. Unless I assured him all of my fiancé's medical bills were taken care of. About a year earlier, she'd spent 2 weeks in ICU after a pretty serious auto accident, which generated a lot of bills since she wasn't insured. At the time, he told me to dump her and tried to keep me from visiting at the hospital. I made up some story about it turning out her parents' insurance could cover it after all. They were military. Dad had never met them and didn't know anything about how military benefits work, so he believed me. It got him to keep quiet for the ceremony. Spent nearly the first 10 years of the marriage paying those bills off. Story 56. I don't know if this fits exactly, but we had our reception at my in-laws' house, and at the end we were supposed to leave in our just-decorated car. Just married, yada yada yada. Well, husband and best man are not sober and just decide to leave together, without me, to go back to our place. So I had to get my friend to drive me across town to my place and yell, and cry a tiny bit, at my husband and his idiot pal. Story 57. At our wedding shower, one of my husband's aunts, who I had never met before that day, walked up to me without greeting and said, "So those invitations, I don't know if you know this, but I have three grown children," to which I awkwardly replied, "Okay, yeah, I have five on the guest list that Ruth M.I.L. gave me." And she goes, "So, what, they just don't get plus ones? Lady, I've never met you or your kids. I don't know your life. I literally just wrote down whatever was on the list your sister gave me." Story 58. My aunt tried to tell me I couldn't invite her ex-husband, who was my uncle for 25 years. She went so far as to say that if I invited him, she wouldn't come. I called her bluff and told her that I'm sorry she feels that, and I hope she would still be able to cancel her hotel reservation. Story 59. My mother tried to pull, "If your father is coming, I'm not coming." I told her to shut up and show up because it is for me and my wife, not her. Needless to say, she insisted on giving a, "It takes a village to raise a kid." Also, my mother was overly concerned we were serving pork at my wedding. I am Jewish, my wife, and the marriage were 100% Catholic. Then it became about the one vegetarian who was attending. Yeah, she can eat the vegetable lasagna. Last but not least, the morning of, my mother said, "It's not too late." WTF. Story 60. I'm probably too late to this game, but a friend of ours offered to do our wedding video as a gift for our wedding. She got completely cow-faced at our wedding, and I literally had to ask her for an entire year if our video was done. She proceeded to tell me I owed her a bunch of money for the video, even though she offered it as a wedding gift. When it was done, it was absolute dog cow. Morale of the story, don't let your friends do your wedding video. Would have been cool to have something to show my kids one day. Story 61. Well, not so much a request, more of a general messed up thing. We had several friends from out of town at our small wedding. The day after the wedding, we met up with our friends for a city tour and food before they took their flights or drove home. Except my best friend didn't drive home. She didn't get a hotel room either, but she did proceed to get to the point she got kicked out of a bar for falling asleep. Of course, we couldn't just leave her stranded 2 hours from home, so we Ubered her back to our hotel and made her sleep in the lobby as we got our license notarized and went to see family. The hotel room we had for only 2 days, because that's how long our honeymoon was. And she spent the night sleeping in the chair in our room and making a drunk scene. At least she offered to sleep in the closet. She's lucky my husband is nice because I would have left her peach in the lobby. We are no longer friends. Who flipping does that? Edited to add, we were only in the vicinity of the initial drunken behavior. We literally watched it happen as bystanders. My exact comment was if I knew we'd have to babysit, we should have brought the kids. Story 62. One of my groomsmen forgot his vest, so he asked my soon-to-be father-in-law if he could borrow his. We were all wearing the same suit, so the groomsmen would all look alike, since it didn't matter if the fought bee had a vest. My fiel went along with it for the sake of us all looking alike, but he's never been a big fan of that friend since. Story 63. When I got married, I did not invite my stepmom because my dad was deceased 4 years before I got married, and I do not get along with her, and my mom absolutely hated her guts and will not be in the same room with her for long periods of time. Anyway, the day before the wedding, my mom, DH, and I are getting food ready for the reception. My mom gets a call from a mutual friend of hers and stepmom. The friend gives this long spiel about how stepmom cares about me. It would mean a lot to her to come. And if my dad were still alive, he would be there with her anyways, so I should just let her come. That was a big hell no, and I almost disinvited the friend right there. We did tell her SM is not welcome, and if she shows up, she will be asked to leave.